So hello everyone and a very good morning to all of you. Welcome back once again to the session of PIB 24/7. I am Manish Mishra and guys, in today's session I will bring to you another 5 important questions from the PIB news. And this session guys is really very helpful for ESI section of RBI Grade B exam. So let's begin with the session, but before we begin, do subscribe to our channel and press this bell icon if you are new here. And also you can join this Telegram group for daily quizzes and updated information about the sessions. So let's begin with the session, and the question number one is Shanghai Cooperation Organization Ministers Meeting for Economy and Foreign Trade was held virtually, in which 4 documents were adopted. Okay, so this meeting was held virtually, jisme ki 4 documents adopt hue hain. So the question is, which of the following is not one of the documents adopted? So let's discuss this news. So India hosted, so that's very important ki kisne host kiya tha is summit ko, India ne. So India hosted the SCO ministers meeting that is responsible for the economy and foreign trade. Okay, economy or foreign trade se related ye meeting hui thi, un sabhi ministers ki jo bhi related hai to the economy and the foreign trade, and it was hosted by India. That's very important. And what was the objective of this meeting guys? So that is to enhance trade and investment, that is critical for ensuring speedy recovery of the economies of the member nations of SCO aftermath of the coronavirus pandemic. कोरोना वायरस के बाद जो हमारे एससीओ के मेंबर नेशंस हैं उनकी इकोनॉमीज की स्पीडी रिकवरी के लिए क्या क्या चीजें क्या क्या स्टेप्स उठाए जा सकते हैं टू बूस्ट द इकोनॉमी एंड द फॉरेन ट्रेड, फॉर दैट दिस मीटिंग वाज हेल्ड. ओके, एंड दीज आर द 4 डॉक्यूमेंट्स दैट वर अडॉप्टेड इन द ड्यूरिंग द मीटिंग. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी हैव स्टेटमेंट ऑन द रिस्पॉन्स टू कोविड-19. ओके, सो दिस डॉक्यूमेंट गाइस रीइंफोर्सेस द नीड फॉर ग्रेटर कोऑपरेशन फॉर access to medicine and facilitation of the trade, and this medicine is for what? Coronavirus. Then statement on the multilateral trading system of ministers of SCO countries who are WTO members. वो जो WTO members countries हैं SCO में उनके लिए multilateral trading system को promote करना है. Then we have statement number 3, which is on SCO cooperation on intellectual property rights. Okay, intellectual property rights में एक दूसरे का cooperation करना है और एक दूसरे के साथ technology को share करना है. Okay, among the nations we have to share the knowledge and information about the intellectual property rights. All right, an action plan for implementation of MOUs to stimulate cooperation within the framework of SCO in the field of MSME. यानी to boost the MSME sector. This 4th document was adopted. Okay, so these are the 4 documents that were adopted during the meeting of SCO ministers who are responsible for economy and foreign trade. Okay, and then remember the name of all the documents. This is for COVID-19, this is for multilateral trading system, this is for intellectual property rights, and that is for MSMEs. Okay, so these are the 4. Just remember the keywords. This is for MSME, this is for IPR. All right, one is for response to COVID-19 and one is for multilateral trading system. So just remember the keywords, then you will be able to recall the name of all the 4 documents. Okay, so let's come to the question. And guys, if you talk about Shanghai Cooperation Organization SCO, so it was created in the year 2001 with the by the leaders of 6 Eurasian nations. Okay, and which are these nations? These are of course China and Russia, one is Tajikistan, then we have Uzbekistan, then we have Kazakhstan, and then we have Kyrgyzstan. So these were the 6 countries that have created this Shanghai Cooperation Organization in the year 2001. Later in the year 2017, India and Pakistan both were joined as a full-time member of this Shanghai Cooperation Organization. Okay, and the Council of the Head of States is the highest decision-making body of SCO. Council of Heads of State is the highest decision making body of Shanghai Cooperation Organization, and also the basic objective of this organization is to promote cooperation among the member nations regarding economy, regarding culture, regarding education, regarding technology, regarding research. Okay, so this is about SCO. Now let's come to the question. Question is, which of the following is not one of the documents adopted? So I told you to remember the keywords. So COVID-19 was one of the keywords, intellectual property rights, MSME, climate change aisa kuch bhi nahi tha. In fact, the one was multilateral trading. Okay, so which means jo hamara ye hai option number 4, ye to statement number 4 hai, that is not one of the documents that was adopted. So therefore option C, only 4 will be the correct answer. And now let's come to the question number 2. Consider the following statements regarding India-UK economic and financial dialogue and identify which is are incorrect. So recently, India-UK economic and financial dialogue हुआ था, उसके बारे में हमें incorrect statement बतानी है. Alright, so it was held virtually, of course, इस साल जितनी भी events हैं, जितनी भी dialogues हैं, जितनी भी summits हैं, that are organized virtually. While in the year 2021, this economic and financial dialogue will be held in London in the year 2021. Okay, अगला जो dialogue होगा, that will be in the next year in London. Okay, and a joint statement of the dialogue was signed between the India and UK. So let's talk about some key points that were there in the joint statement. So first of all, for coronavirus and the global economy, UK research and innovation and India's Department of Technology will jointly invest up to 8 million pounds of joint investment for research on severity of coronavirus. Coronavirus ki severity pe research karne ke liye 8 million pounds invest kiya jayega from both the sides. The UK Department of Health and Social Care will contribute to India's coronavirus joint research plan and antimicrobial resistance via WHO with an initial investment of 6 lakh pounds. Okay. Then for the sustainable recovery, India and UK are working to bring together India's 1.4 trillion national infrastructure pipeline and the City of London, which is a global hub for the green finance. In the year 2018, India and UK launched the Green Growth Equity Fund. That is very important. आपसे एग्जाम में डायरेक्टली यही पूछा जा सकता है कि किस कंट्री के साथ ग्रीन ग्रोथ इक्विटी फंड साइन किया गया था. With which country India has signed, India has launched the Green Growth Equity Fund. So remember, the country is UK. And which is a joint venture with 240 million pound funding to catalyze financing the green infrastructure in India. India के अंदर जो green infrastructure है उसको finance करने के लिए 240 million pounds की funding थी under this Green Growth Equity Fund that was launched in 2018 by both India and UK. And both sides agreed to establish a bilateral sustainable finance forum to boost cooperation between UK and India for the sustainable finance. So guys, these points are important. If you talk about this point, this can be asked in the MCQ format, while other two points you can use in the essay if there is an essay on UK-India relationship. So you can use these points. Alright. And moving on to the next most important point. So these two points are important. So remember these points. A new annual India-UK financial market dialogue. Okay. एक नया annual India-UK financial market dialogue establish किया जाएगा to share expertise, experience and deepen collaboration between the financial sectors of India. जो financial sectors है India उनके बीच, India के और UK के, उनके बीच में cooperation बढ़ाने के लिए this annual India-UK financial market dialogue will be established. Okay. And a new UK-India strategic collaboration to accelerate the development of GIFT City in India. So you must have heard of the GIFT City in Gujarat. And so to accelerate the development of GIFT City, this new UK-India strategic collaboration will be established. Okay, so I hope guys this is clear. And remember some points, this point, okay, these are for the essays. This can be asked in the MCQ format. Both of these points can be asked in the MCQ format. Then if you talk about this, so yes, these two can also be asked in the MCQ format. All right, so now come back to the question. We have to identify the incorrect statement. So it was proposed to establish a new annual India-UK financial markets dialogue. Yes, this is absolutely correct. For promoting the cooperation between the financial sectors of India, this will be established. And it was proposed to establish a new UK-India strategic collaboration to accelerate the development of green infrastructure. No, it is not for the green infrastructure, that is for the GIFT City. Okay, this is for the GIFT City, development of GIFT City in Gujarat. So this statement is incorrect. And next dialogue will be held in New Delhi in 2021. So is that New Delhi? No guys, it is London. It will be held in London. So third statement is also incorrect, which means only 2 and 3 will be the correct answer because we have to identify the incorrect statement. And now let's come to the question number 3. Under Green Initiative, okay, Green Initiative of JBIC. What is JBIC? Japan Bank for International Cooperation. Remember the full form of JBIC, Japan Bank for International Cooperation. So it has a green initiative, and under that initiative, this bank has provided a loan of 50 billion Japanese yen to an organization in India for flue gas desulfurization. Flue gas ke desulfurization ke liye this much amount of loan has been given by JBIC under its green initiative. So the question is, to which organization has the loan been given? किसको लोन दिया गया है. सो लेट्स टॉक अबाउट दिस फ्लू गैस डीसल्फराइजेशन. व्हाट इज दिस फ्लू गैस? सो गाइस, फ्लू गैस का मतलब क्या होता है? लेट अस से दिस इज अ पावर प्लांट एंड दिस इज द एग्जॉस्ट पाइप. ओके, सो दिस एग्जॉस्ट पाइप इज नोन एज फ्लू. ओके, दिस एग्जॉस्ट पाइप इज नोन एज व्हाट? फ्लू. एंड द गैस एग्जिटिंग फ्रॉम दिस फ्लू इज नोन एज फ्लू गैस. ओके, जो बेसिकली जो थर्मल पावर प्लांट्स का या किसी भी पावर प्लांट का जो एग्जॉस्ट होता है उसमें से जो गैस निकलती है उसको हम क्या बोलते हैं? फ्लू गैस. राइट, एंड द कंटेंट ऑफ द फ्लू गैस डिपेंड्स ऑन व्हाट इज बीइंग बर्न्ड इन दिस पावर प्लांट. क्या इसमें जलाया जा रहा है, कोयला जला रहे हैं या कुछ और जला रहे हैं, उसके ऊपर डिपेंड करेगा द कंटेंट ऑफ दिस फ्लू गैस. एंड डीसल्फराइजेशन का मतलब क्लियर है? टू रिड्यूस द कंटेंट ऑफ सल्फर. सो टू रिड्यूस द कंटेंट ऑफ सल्फर इन द फ्लू गैस, विच इज द फ्लू गैस रेफर्स टू द गैस विच इज एग्जिटिंग फ्रॉम द पाइप और द चैनल और फ्रॉम द एग्जॉस्ट ऑफ अ पावर प्लांट. ओके, सो उस गैस के डीसल्फराइजेशन के लिए दिस लोन हैज बीन प्रोवाइडेड बाय जेबीआईसी, जापानीज बैंक फॉर इंटरनेशनल कोऑपरेशन. ओके, एंड द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन गाइस इज एनटीपीसी लिमिटेड. ऑलराइट, एनटीपीसी लिमिटेड को ये लोन दिया गया है बाय अंडर द ग्रीन इनिशिएटिव. एंड व्हाट इज दिस ग्रीन? ग्लोबल एक्शन फॉर रिकंसाइलिंग इकोनॉमिक ग्रोथ एंड एनवायरमेंट प्रिजर्वेशन. रिमेंबर द फुल फॉर्म, दैट्स वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. Global Action for Reconciling Economic Growth and Environmental Preservation is a full form of GREEN, which is an initiative of Japanese Bank of International Cooperation. And out of this 50 billion Japanese yen, 60% will be provided by JBIC, while rest 40% will be provided by the commercial banks of Japan on the JBIC's guarantee. Okay. And talking about the green initiative of JBIC, so under this initiative, JBIC provides enhanced support for environmental preservation to the developing countries. Remember this thing, ये जो initiative है, that is only for the developing countries, because developed countries के पास already इतना resources है that they can utilize that for the environmental preservation, while for the developing countries, there is a scarcity of resources. So for the developing countries, JBIC under this initiative provides support for environmental preservation in the form of loan guarantees and equity financing. Okay, and green projects here includes photovoltaic generation facilities, highly efficient power plants and installation of energy efficient equipment in the factories or the power plants. Okay, this is about the green initiative and the purpose of agreement. If you talk about, so in the question it was already there, the purpose: flue gas desulfurization and renewable energy projects. So the fund will be utilized for flue gas desulfurization and the renewable energy projects by NTPC Limited. Okay, so therefore guys, the correct answer is what? Option C, NTPC Limited will be the correct answer here. And now let's move on to the question number 4. So the question number 4 is based on the electricity access in India and benchmarking distribution utilities report that has been recently released by Niti Aayog. So let's discuss about the report first. Question number 4 and 5 both are based on this report. So remember the name of the report, Electricity Access in India and Benchmarking Distribution of Utilities Report. So kis kis ne launch kiya hai? Niti Aayog, Rockefeller Foundation and Smart Power India. Remember the name of all the organizations. Niti Aayog, Rockefeller Foundation and Smart Power India have jointly launched this report on the electricity access and the utilities, jo distribution utilities hai unke upar. And what was the sample size? So 10 states were included, jisme se 65% of the total rural population of India was covered. And 25 distribution utilities को use किया गया था for making up this report. Okay. And what was the objective guys of this report? ये report क्यों निकाली गई है? So first of all, to evaluate the status of electricity access in India and distribution utilities. Because हमारी government कह रही है that we are now 100% electrified. So उस 100% electrification का status check करने के लिए और जो distribution utilities है उनकी क्या एफिशिएंसी है, वो कितने एफिशिएंटली इलेक्ट्रिसिटी डिस्ट्रीब्यूट कर रहे हैं, उस चीज को मैप करने के लिए दिस रिपोर्ट वाज लॉन्च. एंड बेंचमार्क यूटिलिटीज कैपेसिटी टू प्रोवाइड इलेक्ट्रिसिटी एक्सेस एंड आइडेंटिफाई द ड्राइवर्स ऑफ सस्टेनेबल एक्सेस टू डेवलप रिकमेंडेशंस फॉर एनहांसिंग सस्टेनेबल इलेक्ट्रिसिटी एक्सेस. सो दिस वाज द ऑब्जेक्टिव ऑफ दिस रिपोर्ट. एंड नाउ लेट्स टॉक अबाउट द की फाइंडिंग्स. सो इफ यू टॉक अबाउट द ग्रिड कनेक्टिविटी, so according to the report, 92% of the customers reported the overall availability of electricity infrastructure within 50 meters of their premises. Okay, अपने 50 meter के premises में 92% लोग ऐसे हैं जिनके आसपास electricity का infrastructure है. For agricultural category, this availability rate was about 75%, while overall 87% of the surveyed customers have access to grid-based electricity. जितने भी कस्टमर्स का सर्वे किया गया, उसमें से 87% ऐसे थे जिनके पास ग्रिड बेस्ड इलेक्ट्रिसिटी थी, वाइल जो 13% थे दैट वर आइदर यूजिंग नॉन ग्रिड बेस्ड इलेक्ट्रिसिटी और नॉट यूजिंग इलेक्ट्रिसिटी एट ऑल. ओके, द रिमेनिंग 30% आइदर यूज नॉन ग्रिड सोर्स और डोंट यूज एनी इलेक्ट्रिसिटी एट ऑल. एंड टॉकिंग अबाउट दिस रिपोर्ट मोर, so the hours of supply have improved significantly across the customer categories to nearly 17 hours per day. जो 17 घंटे एक दिन में बिजली आने लगी है अब. Nearly 85% of the customers reported to have a metered electricity connection. Access to electricity is observed in 83% of household customers. Access to electricity household customers में कितनी है? 83% है, while 85% reported that they have a metered electricity connection. Then a total of 66% of those surveyed were satisfied. This fact is very important. This can be asked in your exam. So एक sample survey किया गया, उस sample survey के बाद एक satisfaction survey किया गया. उस satisfaction survey में ये पता चला कि total 66% customers ऐसे हैं that are satisfied from the electricity access and the distribution utilities. And out of this 66% total, 74% are in the urban areas, while 60% in the rural areas. Okay, so this was about this report. And guys, remember one thing, that any report from the Niti Aayog is very important for your exam. कोई भी report आती है Niti Aayog की, वो example है, चाहे वो report में कुछ बहुत अच्छा हो या ना हो. Like for this report, ये बहुत लंबी चौड़ी report है, इसमें बहुत सारे facts हैं. But we don't have to mug up all the facts. These facts are important that I am bringing to you. So just remember these facts only. Okay. And now come back to the question number 4 and 5, which are based on this report. So the question number 4 is, with which foundation? So guys, the foundation is what? Option B, Rockefeller Foundation. Okay, Niti Aayog, Rockefeller Foundation and Smart Power India have jointly launched this report. Question number 5, with respect to electricity access in India and benchmarking distribution utilities report, we have to identify the correct statements. Okay, so 87% of the customers reported to have a metered electricity connection. That is not 87%, guys. Remember, this is 85%, which means this statement is incorrect. Total of 66% of those surveyed were satisfied. Yes, this is absolutely correct. While 85% of the surveyed customers have access to grid-based electricity. Yes, this is not 85%. This is 87%. Alright, so which means we have 1 and 3 which are incorrect, and we have to identify the correct statement, which means option D, only 2 will be the correct answer here. Okay, and guys, yesterday I have given you 2 questions, question number 4 and 5. To kafi kam logo ka comment aaya, kuch zyada logo ka comment nahi aaya, so let me tell you the answer. Given below are some pairs of environmental protocols and conventions with their purposes, identify the incorrect pairs. Now remember, the question says about the environmental protocols. Some students in the answer have written Basel Convention about the banking. Okay, so ये banking वाला नहीं है, ठीक है, banking का Basel Convention है banking के लिए, but in the question it is been asked about the environmental protocols. Okay, so ये जो Basel Convention है, that was not for the proper use of hazardous chemicals, that was for the transboundary movement. Okay, it was for the transboundary movement of the hazardous chemicals. So which means this is incorrect, which we have to identify. Okay, so option E in this question is the correct answer. Okay, and the question number 5, which was about the WTO, World Trade Organization. So ministerial conference is the highest decision making body of the WTO. Yes, this statement is absolutely correct. And WTO is headed by Director General, whose term is 5 years. So remember guys, his or her term is not 5 years, his term is 4 years. And current director general is Roberto Azevedo, and the WTO is headquartered in Geneva in Switzerland. And WTO is an organ of United Nations. No, it is not an organ of United Nations, which means we have second and third as incorrect. Therefore, and we have to identify the incorrect one. So therefore, option A, only 2 and 3 will be the correct answer. So I hope most of you have answered it correctly. Agar aapka answer sahi nahi hai, to aap isme se dekh lijiye answer. Okay. And that's it for the session guys. I hope ये session अच्छा था और आपको अच्छा लगा. अगर अच्छा लगा तो comment करके जरूर बताएं. Thank you so much for watching. मिलते हैं Monday के session में. Goodbye, take care and God bless.